Bill Foley had the vision, the creativity, and the audacity to bring the first Major League team to Las Vegas. And then he said, we're going to win the Stanley Cup in 6 years. What has happened here has been simply incredible. Not only is Vegas a hockey town, it's a championship town. Congratulations to George McPhee, Kelly McCrimmon, Bruce Cassidy, and most important, the players on your Vegas Golden Knights. Mark Stone, our tradition for this 130-year-old trophy is to present it to the captain.
Marchessault hands it off to another original Vegas Golden Knight, William Carlson. We welcome in the great one, our teammate, Wayne Gretzky, who has presented the Stanley Cup on four different occasions. Wayne, describe the feeling.
Well, as an athlete, as a hockey player, there's no better feeling than the first time you get to lift the Stanley Cup. And as you're skating around with the trophy, obviously your teammates are a huge part of that, the coaches, the fans in the city. And then you think about your grandparents and maybe the odd uncle or minor league coaches that helped you get there. And those are the thoughts that go through your mind, that they all are a big part of you lifting that Stanley Cup.
What are your biggest impressions, Wayne, that you will take out of this 2023 Stanley Cup final?
Well, I was just so impressed by both teams. I thought both coaches did an amazing job. Both organizations deserve a lot of credit. Florida played their hearts out. They just happened to run up against a team that was a little bit bigger, a little bit faster, had a lot of depth, and their goalie ended up playing extremely well. They should keep their heads high. They played against a machine in the Stanley Cup Finals. They lost to a really good hockey club.
Chris, you talked a lot about on air and off air. Defended, the importance of being able to play without the puck and bend but don't break at times.
Yeah.
Just the importance of playing that way and eventually winning like you did so many times in your
right.
career.
Let me tell you something. There's nothing more fun than scoring goals in the National Hockey League. We all love to score goals, but I said it last year, I'll say it this year. Defense wins Stanley Cups. When our team learned in Edmonton how to play defense, we became Stanley Cup champions. Eichel was a machine back there. For an offensive player, he was always in the right position, the right spot, and he was their offensive guy that led with a two-way game, and that just trickles through the whole hockey club. They deserve all the credit they're getting. They didn't take a lot of penalties. They killed them when they had to. Defensively, they were strong. They didn't give up a lot of two-on-ones. Ultimately, they became Stanley Cup champions.
Wayne, you won Stanley Cups with an all-time great goaltender in Grant Fuhr, as Jack Eichel is handed the cup from Chandler Stephenson. Wayne Aiden Hill, we saw the photos earlier in the series. He attended your hockey school as a youngster, and now he's a Stanley Cup champion.
Well, we can say now that we've put through a Stanley Cup champion through our hockey schools, right? But know what? People in this game are so wonderful. He's a great example. He worked his tail off. He didn't give up. He was the fifth goalie. I know we talked a lot about this. He was the fifth goalie on the list, and he won a Stanley Cup. And listen, they could have picked one of four or five different guys to win the Conn Smythe, and he was in that mix, no question. Had he probably played in the first round, he might even have had a better chance than anybody. But listen, good for him. What a great story. And like I said, we finally got a guy. We finally have a guy that went through our hockey school and won a Stanley Cup. But listen, I wanted to say to Jonesy, good luck to you, man. We're all going to miss you. And we know you're going to do a great job in Philadelphia. And I know Mr. Schneider's looking down, and he knows you got the right guy to do that job. Good luck to you, Jonesy.
He certainly will. Thanks, Wayne. We look forward to hearing from you and the gang during the post game. It's been great spending the last couple of weeks with you.
All right, guys. Thank you.
Game 5 hero, Mark Stone, is with Darren Panger.
Well, thank you very much, Mark. What did it feel like when you were handed the Stanley Cup by the commissioner?
Unbelievable. Just looked in my teammates' eyes when I got it. One of the craziest feelings I've ever had. Just to know that I did it with my 25, 30 best friends makes it that much more special.
When you were a kid growing up, did it match the feelings you dreamed about?
Yeah, I mean, it's... I can't even describe the feelings in my stomach right now. It's everything you can imagine. The grind of an 82-game season, 4 playoff rounds. You grind and you grind and you grind. And at the end of the day, the last team standing, it's incredible.
And not making the playoffs last year and doing what you did this year. What can you say about your head coach, Bruce Cassidy?
I mean, he came in and brought an intensity to our locker room that maybe we needed. And I think he wanted to win just as bad as everybody else in that locker room. I can see the emotion in his face right now. I don't know what else to say. At all, everybody that's in those four walls, it's amazing.
Go celebrate with your teammates. Congratulations.
Thank you, Banger.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
Back down to Jackie with the Conn Smythe Trophy winner, Jonathan Marchessault.
Jonathan Marchessault, congratulations, an original six misfit. I imagine the vibes are a lot different now than they were in 2018.
Yeah, it was. We waited a long time for that moment to come back, and we want to make sure that we cash in that time, and I couldn't be more proud of our team, our organization. We've grinded for a few years, and I mean, it's just an unbelievable feeling right now.
How would you describe the feeling of the pain of defeat in 2018 to now winning it all and achieving a lifelong dream?
You know what, that's the pain that you can describe too, and that's the feeling that we have right now. It's hard to describe. I mean, that pain was it was tough, to be honest. It took me almost a couple months, a full year to get over it, and because you're so close but so far. And I mean, that time around, I just took a different approach, and look where we are right now. Our team has been unbelievable since the beginning, and we're winners.
What is it about you that makes you so clutch in big moments? I mean, 10 of your 13 goals this postseason either tied the game or gave Vegas the lead. What is it about you that makes you shine when the spotlight is the biggest?
It's one of those things that I just, one night is one guy, one night it's another guy. That's the mentality we had this year. Just next man in has to do the job. And we're a bunch of good teammates in that locker room. And we're always happy for each other, and honestly, everybody stepped up at different times, and that's why today we're winners.
How are you guys going to party and celebrate?
Well, I might not go to bed for a few days here.
As you shouldn't. Congratulations.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
What a postseason for Jonathan Marchessault.
And let's not forget the guy that was the glue on that line, Kenny, with Jack Eichel and Jonathan Marchessault. But Ivan Barbashev late season acquisition by general manager Kelly McCrimmon, along with George McPhee, bringing him in. There were 8 or 10 teams that were all over Ivan Barbashev.
Bruce Cassidy lifts the Stanley Cup for the first time in his career. The Golden Knights will work their way over towards center ice for the team photo. You remember this feeling, Eddie.
A beautiful sight. It's better be right in the middle of that pile.
The Vegas Golden Knights, 2023 Stanley Cup champions.